Hi guys, I'm Marty Core, and back in the day I had a series called Ask You, Ask Me, where I would make a really bad angle with my camera, which is kinda what I did in this video, I guess, but not that bad. And it was basically a Q&A series, but nah, let's just do a normal, regular, traditional Q&A, okay? Let's just call it a Q&A. So I asked you guys if you had any questions on my community tab, and those of you who saw that post, the lucky ones, asked me some questions, so here we go. Do you play only Sims 2, or do you like other games also? Well, it only takes to scroll a little bit on my channel to see that yes, I do play other games, other Sims games, obviously. I am not a huge gamer, I wouldn't say that, but at this moment in my spare time or on my Polish channel, I play games like Niche, my time at Portia. When I had a rough day, I liked to play a few rounds of Worms Rumble. Not really that big on SimCity because I don't know how to play it. Like, recently I got SimCity 4 just in case I want to make a map for The Sims 2. It was really cheap, it was on sale, and I tried to play it a little bit and it was a tragedy. And there is a huge pile of retro and like my childhood games that I still come back to. I even dedicated my Twitch Polish channel to those games. But well, that's in Polish, so yeah. Oh, Stardew Valley, obviously, yeah. Like farm games, simulator games, some shooting games maybe sometimes. I like fighting games too, like Tekken. Or Mortal Kombat or something. And some strategies, but more like retro ones as well. Like Red Alert or Tsar or something. And Heroes of Might and Magic 3 is like my second favorite game right after The Sims. Do you believe The Sims games will improve with The Sims 5, or is the magic of the old games gone for good? I'm afraid it's gone for good, unfortunately. Hey, we have The Sims 2. It's all we need, right? How often do you play any Sims just for yourself these days, with no relation to any YouTube stuff? I have one save file that I've barely showed anyone in The Sims 2, and I've already played like 10 rounds in it. It's a rotational play, of course. It's none of the pre-made towns. So yeah, so that I just play like for my own pleasure, and I especially don't show it to anyone to not like make it public, or, you know, to not feel any pressure towards it or anything, because whenever I show any of my saves, even a very private one, like, or the one that I stopped recording, like Pleasant View, or the second Pleasant View, if I ever show anything, people keep asking me where I am in the gameplay, and honestly, I don't really play it that much. Like, I get bored really fast, I guess, and then I go back to it, and then I get bored again, and, you know, like, I rotate between towns as well, so I even have a save file in Belladonna Cove that I've played for like 15 rounds or something, and I showed it in a live stream once on my Polish channel, and I also don't play there anymore. Like, I think I'd had like a year break in it, so like, it is how it works with Pleasant Views as well and other things that I play. So just have it in mind whenever you want to ask me a question about a private save, if I still play it or where I am or whatever. When it comes to just playing Sims for myself, I think I play it moderately, I guess? I don't know. I try to play other games in my spare time just to not get sick of The Sims too much. But I play it sometimes. Recently, I've been playing a save in The Sims 3, because with the smooth patch, it's so much better. So yeah, I've been kinda getting back to it these days. What is your general opinion on Red Taylor's version? Do you like any tracks better or less than before? What's your favorite song from The Vault? I think I've listened to the whole album only once. I didn't see much point because I already know these songs, you know, but when it comes to The Vault, Of course, the 10-minute version of All Too Well completely blew my mind. If you'd like to see some of my opinions on random things, you can follow me on Twitter. I have a Twitter account and sometimes I post there. But what I don't like is Girl at Home in the new version. And I especially don't like it because I really like the original song. Like, it's one of my favorites. So that was kind of a disappointment, and I got a spoiler from someone that this song is has changed completely, and then I listened to it and I was like, holy crap, what is this? So yeah, this is the one I definitely don't like, and if I feel like switching, you know, my playlist, like replacing the old songs with the new songs, this will be one song, the one song that I will still listen in the old version, because come on. What is your favorite Sims ships? Mine is Skip Broke and Bella Goth, Dina Caliente and Brandy Broke. I don't really ship people that much in other Sims games, so in The Sims 2, in Pleasant View specifically, my favorite ship is Brandy Broke plus Darren Dreamer and Dirk Dreamer plus Lucy Burb. Could you tell us more about your uni experience? Did you find it useful and interesting? What were your most and least favorite subjects, and how hard was it to study? Oh man, okay, that's a big one. The thing I found most useful in my university experience was all the art classes. Like, I started being very interested in art history because of one class, and I had some drawing, I had some digital stuff, even learned basics of video editing at university, so that pretty much led me to starting a YouTube channel, I'm pretty sure. For those who don't know, basically I have master's in like art education, so I technically can become a teacher of art or music or some similar stuff. But I am not, just so you know, I don't work in my field of study. And the second master's I made, like, without the bachelor's, you know, because you can do that in Poland, was librarianship. So I worked at a library for a little amount of time. Definitely the most uni experience I had at the art education studies, because that was 5 years for me. The librarianship was only 2 years. I think my most favorite subject or subjects were the ones where I could learn about history of a certain art. So like art history, music history. I liked the class of music theory, but probably because I didn't really needed that much, because I already had it from music school, so it was like, yeah, I refreshed the knowledge I already had, and I knew a lot in this field already, so it was kind of easy for me. Also, I really liked the class where we played the recorder, like the wooden flute, because I never played it in school. It's such a common thing for Polish kids to learn the flute in school, the recorder, and I just never did for some reason, and I was so happy that I could finally learn. Like, I could just do it at home, you know, but it was actually a thing we had to do at university, learn to play the recorder. Everyone hated it, but I was so happy about it. I was so hyped because it's such an intuitive instrument and it was just so easy to learn to play on it, so yeah. But all I talk about now is the art thing that actually started at like the third year of my studies, I think. And before that, we had a lot of theory on just education in general, pedagogy in general, because pedagogy was like the main field of those studies. The art education was just like a specialty. And when it comes to the general education studies, that was, oh my god, like psychology was very interesting, but this time the history was the worst, because, you know, like the history of social pedagogy or whatever, it was like, there was so much material in there and, oh god. And you just pretty much had to learn it by heart to pass. And some teachers were really strict and, yeah, that was definitely the hardest point. What, in your opinion, are the most underappreciated aspects of Polish culture that you like? There was also a question of more unknown things about Poland that I find oddly charming. Memes about the Pope. Definitely. Like, this is such an inside thing for us that I don't think anyone outside of Poland knows that we meme about the Pope John Paul II so much. People my age and a little bit younger are just crazy about it. We love the number 2137 and the hour, like 9:37 in the evening, because that's the hour when the Pope died, and for some reason we made that meme out of it. It's just like, it's so weird, but it's so funny at the same time for some reason. It's like, and you know, there are like pictures of the Pope where he has a very yellow face or whatever, and some quotes of the Pope that we like to quote or just like rephrase or put them in a completely different context or something. Man, it's fun. Do you have that one song lyric that has been stuck in your mind for the longest time? I know so many lyrics of so many songs that it's freaking hard to pick one line and just have one line stuck in my mind, but I think I could go with one from one of my favorite songs of all time, which is Lost Realist by Trapped. I don't quite agree with what Trapped represents with themselves these days, but their songs are good. Lost Realist is a very special song to me. I think I even mentioned it on the channel once when I was talking about music. And the line goes, "You're gonna have to carve me from stone, right to the bone, or I'll end up alone, playing the role of someone in control. Why do I rush to slow down?" If you could magically learn any language immediately, which one would it be? Italiano. Do you have any language learning tips? Just use it. Go crazy. Oh, baby. No, but seriously, just use it. Even if you don't know much in this language, just try to think in this language. Because only then will you not be embarrassed towards other people, because you're not talking to anyone, you're just in your thoughts. And if you have some words missing or phrases or whatever, you can just always check it. Do you understand other Slavic languages? Asked by someone called Ivan, or maybe like Ivan, I think, Mitkov. So I'm guessing you speak another Slavic language other than Polish. What do you even mean by Slavic languages? There are so many. Like, there's Czech that is probably a lot similar to Polish, like definitely more similar than Russian, but there's also like Serbian or something that I would just completely not understand. So Slavic languages are also a pretty big spectrum, so some of them are really, really different from one another. Especially I wouldn't understand a lot of the languages in writing, because Polish doesn't use the Cyrillic. There are some questions on my channel in the Russian Cyrillic, and yeah, I just have to like decode it to understand it. Because some people apparently think I'm Russian because of my accent, and they ask me if I'm Russian in Russian, and I have no idea what that says. I think I learned to recognize this specific kind of comment, especially that I know more or less how Russian, the word Russian, looks. So in speech, maybe a little bit, some phrases, some words, and in writing, when it's a language that has the Cyrillic, no freaking idea. I've heard English is your job in real life. In what way? Or did I misunderstand it? You didn't misunderstand it. I worked as a English teacher in an English school, like language school. So it wasn't in a regular school. It was just like a company that provides English lessons and any other language lessons pretty much to people that want it, like additionally outside of school or outside of work or just anything like that. So I had the students that were like 14 and just came in after school. I had students who worked at one company, and that company just, you know, like bought an English course for their workers, and I just had like conversations with them or stuff like that to for them to improve their English because they needed it for work. Technically, it was people who wanted to learn the language like half of the time, but the other half of the time it was still kids that were forced by their parents, or I don't know. Anyway, I haven't taken any classes this school year, so it's only YouTube for me these days. But I worked there for like 3 years. What was your biggest dream as a kid? To be in Dragon Ball. What is your favorite movie, show, anime? Which genre do you prefer and which one do you hate? I don't like horrors. I only watch a horror once a year on Halloween and that's it. So also I don't like horror games even more than movies. I don't really watch movies that much in general. When it comes to TV shows, I watch a lot. And my favorite of all time, I think, is the OC. My second favorite of all time is probably This Is Us. That hasn't ended yet, but it will next year. But recently I also watched 6 Feet Under, which is kinda old, even older than the OC. I watched it with my boyfriend, it was the second time for him and the first time for me, and it's freaking good. I mentioned Dragon Ball, but I don't really watch that much anime. Okay, my tea is cold because I forgot about it. Why don't you have your own Facebook group like your good twin sister? Because we share a lot of the audience, it doesn't really make much sense. But I have a Discord for MardiCore that is kinda dead, so if you wanna join it and make it alive again, feel free to do so, the link is in the description. So that was the last one actually, just in time for sunset at 3 p.m. Hey December! If you have any other questions, you can leave them under this video, maybe I'll make another Q&A, like, in a few months or something. It would be nice if you put a little Q in the question so that I know it's meant for the video, not just to reply in the comments, because I do that too. So yeah, I hope I answered burning questions and you found out something interesting about this random person from the internet. And as always, thank you very much for watching, subscribe, like the video, and see you in the next one. Bye! Wow, this room is so gray on this side. And so empty. It's not that empty normally. It's actually pretty messy.